Hello everyone, and thanks for tuning back in. Alessandro De Crypto here. I hope you're all doing fine. So welcome to another episode. In today's video, we're gonna cover, as usual, the Bitcoin price. We're also gonna have a look into the Ethereum price action, and then of course also into the DXY and Nasdaq. So let's start straight here into the Bitcoin price action, because right now here in the 4 hour time frame, you can see that we are still getting supported by the 20 moving average. So yesterday we had here a very explosive move to the upside, and we came right here towards the previous support trend line, which now is acting as a new resistance. And it really looked like that we were about to break it. I also FOMOed into a long position, and currently I'm a bit underwater, but I'm gonna keep alive my long position, because I still think that we're gonna see here continuations to the upside, and pretty soon we're also gonna break this resistance above us, because all time frames are still looking very bullish, and I'm expecting here this breakout to the upside pretty soon, because this is really the last resistance that we have in order to see then new all-time highs and move towards our next targets, towards $70,000. So what I'm expecting here in the next coming hours is a potential attempt to break again here towards 59,000 to 60K to then head towards new levels. But of course, until here, we're not gonna see a breakout through this resistance that we have currently here at around $60,000. There is still this high risk that we could even fall off the cliffs here if we're gonna lose our main support that we currently have here at around $54,000. So right now we are getting another buy signal in the 3 hour time frame. It's not a good one, and it looks also like that here we may be already getting rejected at around $59,700 if we're gonna see here a push to the upside. So it's not a very good buy signal, but at least we have one, and we have now the chance again to head towards this 60K and potentially also break it. We are also back into an uptrend here in the EMA ribbons. You can see here in the 3 hour time frame, we are trading now again above these important EMA ribbons, and the same thing goes also here for the 4 hour time frame. As you can see, we never closed a 4 hour candle again below the EMA ribbons. Yesterday we had a big wick to the downside, but this was bought back up very, very quickly. So it looks like that the bulls are back, and right now we're gearing up here for a possible retest of this resistance that we have above us. So in theory, we should have now enough fuel left to break this 60K, but this is what we're gonna need to see once we are testing this price level again. So far, I still think that we are accumulating here, and we are gearing up for this retest up here, and then we're gonna see if we are able to break through or not. And since a lot of people are always asking me why I go with low leverage or even without leverage into a trade, is simply because I want to sit in a strong position before I increase leverage or increase the size of my position. And you can see, if you go with the 1x into a trade, you have the liquidation price right now very far away, so below $30,000. And I always put a trade right above liquidation price just in order to not get liquidated. And you can see that I put it here $3,000 at 30,000, and we can redo this trade here just to show you where my estimated liquidation price would be if I would enter here with $3,000. If I would add here a $30,000 more into my position, you can see where my liquidation price would be. So if we drop down towards $30,000 and my long position here at 3,000 would get executed, then I would have a position of $8,000, and my liquidation price would come down towards $20,000. So you see, like this, it's almost impossible to get liquidated, but of course you're gonna pay every 8 hours the funding rates. But once you're sitting in a very strong trade, once we are pumping again, then you should be sitting in a very profitable trade. And also then, once you are in profits, you can lock in your gains with a nice stop loss, increase leverage, and also increase your position on the way to the upside. So this trade I'm gonna keep until we're gonna see an explosive move to the upside towards $70,000. And then of course I'm gonna increase leverage and also position size, but until then I prefer to stay here with a low leveraged trade or completely without leverage, because like that I can easily scale more into my long position, since I still expect here a huge breakout to the upside pretty soon. And even if we drop down towards $30,000, I can just increase my position, because I think latest then we're gonna see a huge bounce to the upside, because we are still in an uptrend, my friends, and we just have this last resistance above of us before we could go completely parabolic. And yesterday here in the daily time frame, you can see that we closed below the 9 daily moving average. We were so close to close above, but as you can see, we closed below, and right now of course we are again fighting with this moving average. So let's hope that today maybe we can close above this $58,000. That of course would be in favor for the bulls, that we could potentially go and test this resistance here and potentially also break it to the upside. That buy signal that were flashing yesterday in the daily time frame, of course now is denied, and it's not flashing anymore since we closed below the 9 daily moving average. So we still have to wait here for another buy signal for the daily to appear, and of course also to confirm, and therefore we want to see here at least a daily close above $58,000. That would be very bullish. And of course the 20 daily is right here at our main support of $54,000. So as long as we're trading above this moving average, everything is pointing out that we're gonna see continuation to the upside pretty soon, my friends. And I just have to remind you of here the stochastic in the weekly, because I think that maybe already next week or latest in the beginning of April, we're gonna see here a bullish cross in the stochastic, especially if this week we could close above $60,000. I'm pretty confident that then we're gonna see here a bullish cross in the stochastic RSI, and that could really start the run up towards these levels that we have between 75 to 100K. So I'm pretty bullish for these next coming weeks, my friends, and that's why I want to try to keep alive my long position wherever we are going, even if we would lose the main support of $52,000, because we're still far away from a cycle top here, my friends, and I'm expecting here big continuations to the upside. And we can have a look also into the Ethereum price right now, because here we are still trading sideways. We are still stuck here between these two Fibonacci retracements, and currently we are getting also here rejected by the 9 daily moving average. So also here, as soon as we can close a daily candle above $1,820 and then of course also confirm it, that in my opinion will lead into a massive pump also here into the Ethereum price. It's really weird to see that Ethereum is not making big moves here. But since we are now squeezing between the 20 and 9 daily moving average with a support here of 1,720 and the resistance here of 1,820, I think that very, very soon also here we're going to see a big move potentially to the upside, because also here in my own indicator, you can see that we are cooling off completely here and we are still above the 50 level in the RSI. So in my opinion, also here we're going to see big moves to the upside as soon as Bitcoin is starting to pump. And now let's go over to the DXY. Because yesterday, after we got this massive dump here, you can see that we immediately pumped back up and again retested here the main resistance that we had also here with this ascending triangle. So we're still getting this resistance here, and even though we have seen now this pump, I still lean more to the bearish side, that here we're gonna see very soon continuation to the downside, even though we could here break out to the upside and retest the 200 daily moving average up here at $92.70. I still think that here most likely latest here at $97 we're gonna see then a big rejection and continuation to the downside. So this pump that we have seen yesterday was here right at the 20 daily moving average. We got supported here, and we also have here now a buy signal flashing. So it is possible that in the next coming hours and days we might see continuation towards the 200 daily moving average, but overall I'm still very bearish for the DXY, and latest here I'm expecting a big rejection. So be prepared that the DXY could maybe see continuation to the upside, but let's see what happens if we are reaching here the 200 daily moving average. And if we have a look now into Nasdaq, you can see that also yesterday we had a big dump here. So whatever the reason is why we have seen this big dump, the important thing is now that we can immediately recover back up above the 9 and 20 daily moving average here at $13,000, because otherwise this of course could lead into a massive correction even down towards the 200 daily moving average here at $12,000. So let's hope that today, latest next week, we can immediately recover above here the $13,000 level, because otherwise we are back into bearish mode for Nasdaq, and that of course could also be a bearish sign for the crypto market. So for whatever reason, yesterday we had seen this big dump even down towards the 20 and 9 daily moving average. I still think that the Nasdaq is looking still bullish and we should expect here a very fast recovery. So whatever was the reason that we have seen this big dump, I think it's just a short-term price driver that caused this big dump, and we should expect here a fast recovery straight back up above the 9 and 20 daily moving average as soon as possible. Otherwise, we could really start to drop here towards $12,000, and then of course also create here lower highs and lower lows, and that would be quite bearish, even though here at the 200 daily moving average I'm expecting a huge bounce. But of course that's always a bearish sign once we are creating these lower highs and lower lows. So let's hope that the Nasdaq is able to recover as soon as possible from this bearish situation that we are in right now. Because if we are able to create here again higher highs and higher lows, then I'm pretty confident that also in the crypto market, especially here for Bitcoin, we're gonna see also here a very fast recovery and create new all-time highs pretty soon. So the conclusion for this video, my friends, is that most likely we're gonna see here some sideways price actions, maybe even go up here to retest the main resistance at around $60,000, and then of course we're gonna see if we are able to break it or not, because once we are breaking this main resistance here at around $60,000, then we also gonna take out this all-time high here of $62,000 that we had and gear up towards our next targets way above the old all-time high. I'm still leaning more to the bullish side. That's why I also still keep my long open, because I still believe that we're gonna see here continuation to the upside pretty soon. So let me know in the comment section, what do you think? Are we gonna see here a huge crash down towards 30,000 next, or are we able to push it towards $75,000, our next bullish target, if here we can take out this all-time high of $62,000. Let me know in the comment section, my friends. I'm really interested. What is your opinion? What will be the next big move of Bitcoin? And don't forget that we have this special Femex Trading Arena coming up here on the 24th of March. Make sure to join it, because the more people we are, the bigger the prize pool will be. You have still 4 days left to register to this tournament. We can win currently up to 3 Bitcoin, but if we're gonna share this link that you find in the video description to all your friends that are trading Bitcoin with the leverage, then we can win up to 45 Bitcoin. So make sure to share the link with all your friends. And if you want to join me and my community, then make sure to join this Chinese team. In the last competition of Femex, I was with this same Chinese guy, and we were second at the end. So we won a little bit of the prize pool, not that much, but at least we won a little bit. And that's why if you want a slight chance to win the tournament, then use the link down below here and join our team. And for everyone that don't want to trade with leverage themselves but want to try it out, then check out PrimeXPT, because here you can also do some very nice gains if you're following the right traders, because here you can easily just copy trade other successful traders by clicking here follow once you opened up here an account, and of course also put some Bitcoin. So check out all my referral links down below here in the video description, because if you're using my referral links, you support the channel, and also you will get some extra bonus if you use my invitation links. And before we're gonna wrap this up, a big shout out to our great Discord trading chat. If you want to be part of our great community here on Discord, then make sure to use the official link that you find only down here in the video description to my Discord trading chat. Once you have clicked on this invitation link, you have to go here to read first and then click here on this thumbs up button to confirm that you're a human and not a bot. And like this, you have free access to the trading chat. And if you also want to get access to my live stream indicator, where you can see always 24/7 my indicator giving you buy and sell signals for Bitcoin, then you have to contact me here on Discord with a private message, because a small donation is needed to get access to it. And otherwise, you can just use the membership option here to get access to the live stream indicator. And then, of course, you also have to contact me over on Discord. So if you like the content, my friends, make sure to hit that like button. Also subscribe to the channel. I do daily TA videos, and we're gonna see us all in the next one. Bye.